From Las Vegas, it's theCUBE, covering EMC World 2016. Brought to you by EMC. Now, here are your hosts, John Furrier and Dave Vellante.
Okay, welcome back everyone. We are here live in Las Vegas for EMC World 2016. This is SiliconANGLE's theCUBE, our flagship program. We go out to the events and extract the signal from the noise. I'm John Furrier, my co-host Dave Vellante, here for our seventh year of EMC World. Our next guest is Peter Kutz, who's the Vice President of Engineering Solutions at VCE, Converged Platforms Division of EMC. Welcome back to theCUBE, good to see you.
Thank you, good to see you.
So I gotta ask, converged is everything that's been around for a while, but now the definition's changing, you're starting to see the shift happening where the two groups within EMC, traditional, core, and emerging, have their swim lanes, it's pretty clear, flash working across both. You got scale out, you got extreme IO, you got all this good stuff happening. The customer's got to put it all together. So what's the new kind of revelation this EMC world from your standpoint around that journey? Because cloud is in the equation. What's going on?
So I think when you look at it, converged platforms and converged platforms is really the new thing we'll talk a lot more about. And so what it really is the combination, as you said, not only of a system, which could be a V-block, VX block, could be a VX rack, could be anything that the blocks, racks, or appliances, but then actually tying and raising that kind of what I would call value curve up into cloud, whether it's platform two or platform three, which we'll talk about with either enterprise hybrid cloud or native hybrid cloud. But then also workload solutions, putting actual applications onto the platform. So when you think about it, it's the combination of a system and the actual solution that goes on it into one outcome. And that's what the customers are really looking to do. And Chad kind of summed it up across the presentation earlier today, which is, you can start with best of breed components, but customers don't want to plug those together and figure it out. They want to buy the outcome so that they can focus on the core things that they're really, they need and what they're trying to achieve in their business. So that's really the key.
What's stopping people? I mean, early on, the early days of VCE was kind of a heavy lift, right, with converged infrastructure. It feels like there's a tailwind now with the digital transformation. People say, I can't spend time doing this heavy lifting anymore. I want to buy the solution.
Okay. Yes.
But there's still some holdouts. Why are they holding out? What's the if there is any headwind, what is it?
Well, I think the headwinds can be multiple things. I think there's a lot of teams who still want to go out there and build. And that's absolutely, as Chad said earlier today, and kind of referenced, it's like build or buy, you make the decision, you decide where you want to invest and how you want to invest into your resources. And so from a standpoint of the barrier, I'd say it's customers still want to build because that's in their nature and they want to do these things. But until they've been through a longer project of figuring out that it's much harder to build than actual buy, that's actually what usually is the barrier. And once they go through that, they're usually right on board. They're like, I get it, I don't want a life cycle, I don't want to have to go through all the things that I need to go through. And by the way, if I'm a bank or if I'm a hospital or if I'm in any type of industry, I want to be focused on my customers and the applications that touch them. I don't want to be focused on building infrastructure for them. And I want to automate your resources so that I don't have to worry about when they get the resources they want. They get it when they need it, and that's the key. Mm-hmm.
Chad had demos and the capabilities, new capabilities, and the future concept around enterprise hybrid cloud on stage. Got a lot of rave reviews. He's a great technical presentation. But I want you to explain, what is that and why do customers care? And is that the same as native hybrid clouds? I hear two terms.
Yeah,
I hear enterprise hybrid cloud and I hear native hybrid cloud. Are they the same or compare? Share with us your thoughts on that.
Yeah, sure. So when you think about the days and the way they're set up today, today was modernized the data center. And it was really about taking those platform two applications that are built for traditional blocks and can still run on racks and appliances, but ultimately focused on traditional applications that are out there, stack-based. And it's about automating the delivery of those, taking out the barriers of IT, delivering services with those. And so the service catalog and the end user portal for EHC or Enterprise Hybrid Cloud is really targeted at a line of business or an application owner or someone who's used to that stack-based approach where I've got some type of database, a middleware, and a web presentation.
Business objectives, the work streams behind it.
And they need backup and recovery, and they need disaster recovery, all in a self-service portal, and they don't want to have to call anybody to do anything, but they still have to pay for it through chargeback and showback. And so that's really what the Enterprise Hybrid Cloud does. And that's one of the things that we've seen. If you can automate Platform 2, you're going to cut cost. And that's what you saw in the statistics and the numbers
from
the customers.
Platform 2 being the reference to traditional IT data centers and whatnot.
Traditional applications, so traditional applications. Now, when you look at native hybrid cloud, which we've announced, and obviously you'll see a lot more about this tomorrow, and Drew will be on after to explain quite a bit more, it's really focused on that true digital transformation, the customer who's made the trip and said, I'm going all in and I'm doing this digital transformation. And so the native hybrid cloud is completely focused on that, and what it's built on is actually, you know, Pivotal Cloud Foundry is the core, so a cloud native platform, so they're starting there. And then it's a turnkey delivery package on the right infrastructure, which is completely scale out, which would be a rack.
So would it be safe to say that the native hybrid cloud is a developer cloud on top of industry standard scale of infrastructure?
Yes, exactly. And the key to this, though, is that we've gone a step further, and we've actually built a portal that allows the developers and the operators to talk about the same language. What I mean by that is, in the portal, in the Pivotal Cloud Foundry instance, where the application is running and the name and the status, all of that can be pulled out from the Native Hybrid Cloud toolkit, and the operations team actually can understand, speak the same language, and understand everything that's going on with the apps inside of Pivotal Cloud Foundry. So it's a great dashboard. They can do showback, chargeback, and actually treat this as an enterprise-type solution, even though they're doing digital transformation.
Can you take us through this sort of the anatomy or life cycle of an engagement with a customer that says, okay, starts with the outcome. This is the outcome I'm looking for. What is that outcome, and how do they engage with you, and how does it manifest itself into a solution?
Yeah, so I mean, from a standpoint of enterprise hybrid cloud or any of the kind of robust solutions, you know, you're going to go in and you're going to ask them exactly what their outcome is, but you got to make sure they have a business leader who's sponsoring them or a partner that will actually consume the resources. Because just because you can provide, you know, kind of what I would call seamless access to resources, it doesn't mean people understand how to use that or sell that internally to IT. And so the first thing we do is go in and figure out exactly what they need for their business, and get a partner that actually will work with them to do it. And then, of course, now you start to get success and it grows exponentially internally. So you have to help them also through a transformation, because remember, in kind of the way things were always done, people touched everything and really interacted and assigned IP addresses and did all the things manually. That's all automated, right? Everything from the firewall rule to the VM to the app, it's all done in a single provisioning operation by the end user. Again, with, of course, they have to have the appropriate permissions to do so. And so that's how the engagement starts, and you get them started and they start to grow, and that's the footprint that actually helps them automate and deliver better services.
And do they, are they targeting a suite of apps or a particular app or?
Well, so from a standpoint of the Enterprise Hybrid Cloud, which would be Platform 2, they'll just take a suite of apps. They're going to take everything they can, and if they can put it on there, and we have day two operations that allow them to ingest very, very easily and add all the cloud semantics, it's great for them because now they've taken all the manual operations away from that application and they can lifecycle it, they can take care of it from there.
And technically that's essentially a mapping exercise? Or, yeah. Okay.
Well, and it's kind of automated now because we've built some tools to help ingest those running workloads.
But you're automating that mapping.
For them, yes. Right. So it pulls it right in. Right. The second piece, though, is the second piece of the engagement is a native hybrid cloud engagement. That's a little different. That's a customer who's said, basically, I'm going to go all in on cloud native platform, I'm going to do it differently, pair programming, whatever your approach may be, but I'm going to use a tool like Pivotal Cloud Foundry, and I'm not going to care about the stacks or the infrastructure. I'm going to trust that someone does that for me below that, and that's what the native hybrid cloud really delivers.
Okay, and that's maybe a line of business?
Line of business, developer.
And they're getting a solution.
They don't know,
what do they know about that solution? What do they know about where their data is?
That's a good point. So especially in cloud native, one of the things you can't forget is that the actual data that is persistent needs to be protected, and we've built in protection into the platform. Also, the Pivotal Cloud Foundry semantics, the build of Pivotal Cloud Foundry and the code repositories are also automatically backed up as part of the solution, so data protection is actually embedded into it. And then the other piece of this is just making sure they have the ability to, again, meter, monitor, make sure they understand what's going on in the infrastructure, all built in. So they don't have to go figure all those things out on their own.
Go ahead, John.
We got a question from the crowd chat here. It says, on the native hybrid cloud, challenge is getting cloud computing to act on systems of record data, much of which isn't leaving the data center anytime soon.
Which
brings up a question, right? Okay, multiple data. So DevOps essentially is almost mainstream, it's getting there, it's not fully, but still software's still the center of the conversation. Talk about that dynamic, because software innovation's happening.
Yes.
And the systems of record data usually is on-prem.
Yes. So a couple of things. The way you'd look at that is it depends on the system of record data and where it's sitting. That's where the enterprise hybrid cloud, where you're, if it's sitting on an Oracle database or some type of traditional SQL, MySQL, those things are going to be sitting on reliable VBlock, VXBlock, one of those reliable systems. But the DevOps can still happen. It's just that they're accessing the Oracle instance on the more reliable infrastructure. So the data persistence stays there. That's one model. The other model is you go into a completely brand new kind of database restructure, really go all in, and now you're talking about converting into a completely cloud native platform. So either way is the choice, but a lot of customers are leaving those systems of record there and just doing the DevOps and the actual—
So incremental optimization on top of it.
That's right. Now the other thing that a lot of customers are doing is they're focusing on things like analytics as part of it. So when you deliver these new digital media apps, they usually produce a lot more data. And so part of the other package, you know, when I think about everything that we're doing, and I'll summarize it this way, we're focused on a higher level individual to be able to deliver an outcome, and you said this well. We're focused on a developer, an application owner, or we're focused on a data scientist. So we have a solution that effectively allows a data scientist to take data sets, actually modify them, share them, do all of this through a self-service portal. So when you think about the cloud and how you can tie it all together, developers, data scientists, and application owners can all get automation and understand each other.
So a whole new set of personas for you guys. And I know we're tight on time, but when I think of historically, the EMC solutions, I think of SAP, I think of Oracle, I think maybe VMware, I think of storage admins inside of those groups. Well, how has that changed? How is that changing?
Well, so we're covering both. We don't want to say that we're not doing the other, and we actually give a lot of airtime to the new because it's where people are going. But people still need to understand how they run their traditional applications, and they need to know where they place them, what they should choose. And so what we've done is spent a lot of time also focused in the workload solutions teams to look at SAP, Oracle, SQL. 90% of VCE customers run mixed workloads on the same VBlock or converged infrastructure. That is extremely high. The challenge is the industry's trying to go to stack-based, like if you go into the appliances model. And so when you look at the value VBlock has and some of the work we're doing in the other part of solutions is to show customers how they can stack those applications and multiple workloads on the same platform, get the performance they need, all flash changes the game, of course, here, and then allow them to understand how to data protect it and give it its life cycle. So huge other focus of the team. Those are the four key areas.
But definitely stark contrast to some of your competitors. I mean, it's Republicans and Democrats, John.
pick your religion. Peter, thanks so much for coming on theCUBE, sharing your insights and explaining the difference in enterprise hybrid cloud and native hybrid cloud, two distinct and different but not mutually exclusive scenarios for your customers. I'll give you the final word in the segment. Share with the audience, what's the real revelation this year at EMC World 2016?
I think the revelation is what you guys have highlighted the most here, which is really the journey we're on and the personas that we're chasing that we wouldn't have been before. And I think you can see it echoed through the presentation material, echoed through the halls and the chambers and the demonstrations and the things we're doing with customers. So I would say really, helping our customers make that journey to actual business transformation, digital transformation, and helping them on the journey of making the decision, if you want to build it, we're here, but if you want to buy it, we've got it.
Peter Kutz, VP of Engineering Solutions here on theCUBE. Extracting the signals from the noise, I'm John Furrier with Dave Vellante. You're watching theCUBE at EMC World 2016. We'll be right back after this short break. Looking back at the history